Right, today we are going to be talking about the brand new core plugin for Obsidian, Bases. Bases is something that has been known to be like in development. It's kind of a first-party data view replacement, and we got a early access version, so you have to be a early access catalyst license holder. It's, I think, $25, one-time payment, completely optional. All you get is the early access stuff before it goes to the public release that everyone has access to. And they say this feature will be in early access for longer than the updates typically are, which is probably about 2 weeks, 3 weeks. It seems to be pretty quick usually. And so Bases is a core plugin that lets you turn any set of notes into a powerful database. With Bases, you can organize everything from projects to travel plans, reading lists, and more. I've got a screenshot right here. We've got some columns. We've got an arrow here. You can tell you can clearly toggle how it's formatted, how it's sorted, rather. We got some menus up here. So very cool, very cool. Boom, that's it. So I've already got one set up here. I use the MediaDB plugin that lets me easily add notes that have metadata for movies, TV shows, books, things like that, and then you can mark them as having watched them, and you can rate them and do stuff like that. And so I've got one for movies, and so the way that it works basically is bases are files. They are .base files, so they are going to be sitting as their own file inside of your vault somewhere, and you can make one by right-clicking on a folder and going new base, or you can make one by doing the old command palette, type in bases, and you got create new base, copy table to clipboard, and there's going to be some other stuff as well. So once you've got a new base, you're going to go to filters, and you can just add the different filters that you want. So by default, let's make a new base. Let's recreate this movie one. New base. Movie base. So by default, you get everything that's in your vault. If we go to filters, we can say just the stuff that is tagged with a certain thing. So we'll go MediaDB. So anything that's tagged with MediaDB TV movie will be like the main filter of this base right here. So by default, we've got just the name. If we go over here to properties, it's gonna have everything that's available in this batch of notes here. And we can just click it, toss it on there. Whatever you want. And then, of course, for every note, it's going to have the kind of inherent properties, created times and file names, stuff like that, path. You can easily mess with the appearance of it, the sizing of the columns. You can drag on the name, move them over, do whatever you want. We don't even need to have the name over that name. It can be wherever the frick we want. It's super simple. And then you can get, if you click on it, you can sort it. Just super easy, toggle. So very cool, very nice. And you can see we've got, if it's a multi-property thing in there, like director, there's multiple ones here, different actors, multiple actors. You've got all of them listed here. It's pretty neat. And then we can also go, and then we'll take off, let's take off the actors. So watched right here, this is a checkbox. We can toggle it on, toggle it off. Pretty neat. You still have just a table view. There will eventually be other ones, but you can't do like a card view or a list view or anything like that yet. One thing you can do is you can add other views to this base. So this is the default grouping we got here. Anything tagged with the MediaDB one. All right, so we've gone add view. We've given it a name. We went up to filters and we added where watched, which is a YAML front matter property in all of the nodes, is not checkmarked, filled in. So it's going to filter out and just show us the ones that do not have a checkmark. Now, I do not diligently keep these up to date. So I've seen that one. Definitely seen all the Ernest movies. All of them are classic. But so you can just check them off and they're going to go through and filter out when they don't meet the criteria. And by that same view, you can go add, and eventually we'll have a different stuff we can do. Boom. So doing that same thing, we can make a new view. We can go where watched is checked this time instead of is not. And we don't even have to have that watched property in the table. It's still going to just filter for you. Filter it by that, even if that isn't there. So like, why would you, you're not going to uncheck watched it. You're not gonna go, oh yeah, I actually didn't watch it, right? Most likely. So you can do that there. You can have the last watch. You can move that here. We can have it sorted by that. So we can kind of see, you know, it's pretty serviceable now, I think. Now, the one last thing that I'll show you that I haven't done yet, so we'll see if this works well. Let's do a new regular markdown note. One of the main benefits for Dataview is that it doesn't have to be its own file or its own note. It can be a part of another note. It can be kind of embedded in there with the Dataview queries. And that is something that we are supposed to be able to do with bases. So let's see how that worked. Now, if we go command palette, bases, create new base, insert new base. So insert new base. I don't know if that means if we can't pick a base file we already have or how that works, but let's see. And it's just like any other. Movie base dot base. So look, we've got a little link right to it. That is sick. That is sick. And just like embedding or transcluding anything else, there we go. It's right there. I don't know if we can kind of like limit the amount of queries that get returned, the amount of results that get returned, you know, like if we just want the 10 most recent or something like that. But if we, it's fully functional. We got the whole different views right down there that we can just toggle between. We can do all those type of sorting stuff that we normally would do. So that's that. Like, that's pretty neat. It doesn't seem like you can do any of the kind of inline data view stuff with this, and I don't think that would ever be something that would fit this type of plugin. So it's not going to be a one-to-one replacement ever, most likely. And honestly, because Dataview is the backbone of a number of plugins, I don't know if it's even possible for there to be a future where those plugins can rely on the basis core plugin or Dataview, or if they switch over. Currently, that's not possible. There is a little roadmap for bases, which is very minimal with zero time frames, not even like Q4 or anything like that. But there is no API for plugins to work with bases yet, but that's coming. And then view types, list cards, etc. Grouping files and aggregation functions is coming. And then, of course, Obsidian Publish support will be there eventually. So if you've got early access, this is something you can toy around with. So yeah, very cool, very interesting. Go check it out. Brand new core Obsidian plugin.